Welcome back. You're watching Bio. Let me continue the discussion here. Let's bring in our first caller, Mr. Ali Asghar Khambati, if we have him. He's calling us from Hyderabad. He's a fair bit of investments in the mutual fund space. We'll, of course, come back to Sanjeev in a minute, talk about various other aspects of the insurance side. Also, keep on taking questions from our callers. Mr. Ali Asghar, if you are with us, let's go ahead with your query, sir.
Good morning to everyone. I think I have the portfolio listed with you. I have an HDFC top 200 and I have about 16 to 18 schemes in which I have done SIPs of various amounts. My goals include planning for a house within the next 5 years and a retirement surplus of about 2 crores by the time I am at least 55 years of age, with a monthly income of about a lakh of rupees. So I would like to know whether the allocation which I have done in the current mutual funds is a good option, or is there any better alternative which will give me diversification among all different fund houses, sectors, themes, asset classes, and risk aversion.
Okay. Anil, let's start with you. Do you think he should look at consolidating his portfolio first, try and cut down on the number of funds that he has, and of course, your opinion on the portfolio that he has right now?
Sure, I'm completely in agreement on that. You know, there are a whole lot of funds there. I think something like 16, 18 funds. So much of diversification is not going to help. It's going to become difficult to track and stuff. What are one or two things one can do in terms of consolidation out there? One is definitely, you know, I'm a little against some of the sectoral funds. So maybe one could, you know, ease out some of them. When is a sectoral fund required for somebody as an investor? An active investor, you know, understanding markets, looking at stocks, tracking sectors is something, you know, where one can use sectoral funds. And then you say, okay, I want to exit from this sector, I want to enter into this sector. So that's more suited for a more active fund style management there. So that's the first place that, you know, I would like to go and see, let me, you know, move out. The second is maybe look at a more strategic allocation across the whole portfolio. You know, decide on what is the debt and equity that one wants to have. So if, you know, based on studying one's own risk appetite, you say, okay, I want at least 25% in debt. Then, you know, you look at what are the funds within debt and what are the funds in the, for the 75% in terms of the equity side. The next level would be to go and to say that, yes, let me then look at what are the different market cap allocations. Say that, yeah, I look at large caps for maybe 30% of the portfolio. I will look at flexi cap for maybe another 30-40%, and the balance then I go and put into mid caps there. This mix again would depend on, you know, one's risk appetite there. So while, you know, many of the funds he has chosen, I think, are decent funds, I would believe that, you know, one could consolidate into, you know, after doing this analysis and then coming out, say, okay, I'll, in the large cap, I will focus on two companies there, two funds, say, HDFC equity and, you know, maybe another fund there. And similarly, you know, say, in the flexi cap side, I will do these two funds, and on the mid cap side, you know, so then you have a good strategic way of looking at it, and you can also track markets and, you know, monitor your portfolio in a much better way.
Sanjeev, so one thing which we are in agreement is that consolidation should be done. But that aside, what would you suggest in terms of his portfolio structure?
See, my suggestions would also be very, very similar, because I think you're over-diversified. The way I like to do is that you must invest in only two or three scripts or two or three mutual funds in a particular segment. So if you're looking at large cap, have your favorite two or a favorite three if you have a lot of time. And then second thing is the flexi cap, because you know that at the end of the day, the fund manager in most likelihood will be able to do a better job than you in choosing which cap to be invested in depending on the market situation. So have a two favorite flexi caps, and then you can have some mid cap holdings. Again, on sectoral holdings, my belief is that as an individual investor, you should not go and take sectoral calls. And you know, at max, that if you are from one particular sector and you believe that this sector like power or XYZ is going to do phenomenally well and you like to be invested in that sector, then probably you can have one or two mutual funds that you can pick up there. But I think your portfolio is pretty good. In fact, I think you do a lot of research, watch a lot of channels. So you have picked up most of your funds that you have picked up are very, very good funds. But consolidate. Please reduce the size to 6 to 8 so that you can give more focus to your portfolio.
Okay, fair enough. Let's bring in Nikhil Parmar, who's joining us from Ahmedabad. Nikhil, hi. What would you like to know?
Yeah, sir. Actually, you are getting my mail.
Yes,
actually,
absolutely.
Mutual fund is not very for me, but I am investing in that insurance. It's a little bit worry for me.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, I investing. 1,250 rupees per month in Tata AIG Life Invest Assurance Flexi,
insurance.
And 8,000 per six months in ICICI Prudential Life State Pension,
mm-hmm.
And 16,000 per year in LIC Insurance Jeevan Anand.
Okay.
Yeah, it's cover up to me approximately 7 lakhs, and that is not enough for me.
Hmm. Nikhil, are you a family man? Are you married? Do you have kids as well?
No.
Okay. All right. Sanjeev?
So I think that can I stop this in this ULIPs and pension plan, and I take one term plan and remaining amount invest in mutual fund?
Okay, fair enough. Sanjeev, you heard the question, but my issue is, do you think he's the amount of cover that he has is very, very minimum? 7 lakhs, I think he told that's the kind of cover. Do you think he's 29 years old, he's earning, so I believe he must have some dependence on him. Do you think 7 lakhs is not enough risk cover for him?
No, 7 lakhs is not enough. See, even if you're not married, you need life cover because your parents are dependent on you. The Indian family structure is that parents do depend on their children, and at the end of the day, you do have to pay some attention there, because in India, we spend a lot of our earnings and savings on giving a better life to our children. So what they say, that the simple rule of thumb that you can follow is that when you are not married and you have dependent parents, then you must have 5 times of your annual income as a life cover. So suppose a person's annual income is 5 lakh rupees, then he must carry a life cover of 25 lakhs. Once you get married, this amount should go up to 8 times with one kid, 10 times with 2 to 3 children, then your life cover should be about 12 times of your annual income. And what I'll say is that I agree with you. It's about time that you should restructure your portfolio. According to me, pension doesn't make sense, because pension, at the moment, you're getting a tax benefit, but the maturity corpus is going to be majorly taxable. So 70% of the money that you're going to collate is going to be taxable. So you can look at surrendering your pension on completing 3 years. In case of the Tata AIG product, it's a ULIP. Again, if you continue this product for a 15 and 20 year horizon, then it will give you a decent return. So there, I will say that treat it like a normal mutual fund, and you can continue with that product, because being a normal, simple ULIP product, it gives you a tax-free corpus in spite of the fact whether you're invested in debt and this thing. On Jeevan Anand, that's a traditional plan. See, Jeevan Anand gives you a whole life cover, but at the end of the day, it's a traditional plan which will give you a return equivalent to a bank FD. So you will have to take a call whether you want to continue with it. You are happy with a 6-7% return, but you must also have some debt in your portfolio. So there, yeah, I'll say that the call is yours. You can take a call, but pension you can get out of. And in the case of term plan, what I'll recommend to you, either go in for a low cost term without return of premium plan, or the better still is that my favorite is a term with return of premium plans, like the new Aviva Life Shield Advantage, which has a zero lapse guarantee. That means after 3 years, even if you forget to pay the premium, then your proportionate life cover continues. So that's a very good plan for you, which you can pick up.
That's amazing, actually. We don't get to see such kind of plans. I mean, is it a recent introduction?
Yeah, it's a very recent introduction. See, what happens in a term, a lot of people don't realize, is that in case of terms, a lot of claims don't get paid. The reason is that a person typically doesn't die on the spot. He dies due to a critical illness, and during the first thing you forget when a person has a critical illness is to pay the premium, because in India we think if we think positive things will happen. So no other family member would go and say first thing is pay the premium. So they'll say, no, if I think like that, then something will go wrong. So what happens in a lot of cases, people forget to pay the premium. Now, Aviva has understood that need, and in case the new generation covers which are now being filed with IRDA, they are already going in, they are giving a no lapse guarantee where they say, okay, if you have paid the premium for 5 years and it was a 25-year policy, then you will at least get the proportionate life cover. So that's a major advantage that is there for an individual. So you can look at, so Life Shield Advantage is the first plan which carries that benefit. I'm sure within the next few months, there'll be a lot more plans which are carrying that advantage.
Mm. Anil, let's get your suggestion for the investor. Nikhil, what should he do?
So I think the first big question is, you know, what type of insurance cover that he should be using, you know, considering his age and, you know, the background, etc. I think at this time, the best would actually to be, you know, term cover, especially for the younger generation, where the income levels also will be a little lower than, you know, as age goes by. It actually makes sense to focus a little more on, you know, term covers there. So definitely, I think that could be one way of looking at what is, you know, the cover that one needs. And if one ends up, you know, surrendering any of these policies, then you can go and add up the cover through, you know, a term cover type of plan there. I think the second, broadly on the recommendation, I am also in sync, you know, basically that, you know, one is on the traditional policy, you know, you have a lot to lose. So even though, you know, it may be a poor returning one, you'll have to think twice on whether you want to lose out this money, because surrendering it will, you know, give you nothing much. And you may just end up being forced to continue with that. Okay, the life stage pension, yes, I agree that at this time he doesn't need, pension is not his priority. Secondly, we believe that pension plans, because they are taxable, are best avoided. Even if one is planning for pension, maybe you can use a ULIP, which has some bit of life cover there. If you look at the life cover cost in the overall scheme of your ULIP, is not, you know, the real big cost there. So, you know, one would rather look at a ULIP type of plan than, you know, a life stage pension, even if it means that you want to take care and plan for a pension need there. On the Tata AIG, I would believe that I would, you know, before continuing, I would want to relook and just look at the charge structures, because IRDA has, you know, changed the charge structures very well. And look at it now, past is past. Now, if I continue this plan for the next 5 years or 10 years, what is it, you know, the cost adding up to? And if, on the other hand, I buy in a new plan, what is the cost adding up to? So I think one would take a call broadly based on that. And assuming that, you know, you finish the minimum, the 3 years, and there's no surrender charge, etc., then, you know, a decision like this can be looked at. But broadly, one is not averse to, you know, continuing that for some time, considering that one may have already paid a large part of the charges. And, you know, you don't want to be missing out on the lower charge years out there.
Okay, we'll take a break, come back. Welcome back. You're watching Buy or Sell. And of course, it's a Friday mutual fund special right here on the show. Let's welcome in Jatin Verma. He's an engineer joining us from Bangalore. Jatin, hi. What's your question? Okay, well, Jatin wants to know, he has a portfolio of HDFC top 200. He invests 2500 per month into that. He wants to know, could you please advise me into other good performing funds, whether they are multi-cap, mid-cap or various other funds. He wants to invest around 2500 or more into mutual fund space. Anil, straight to you. What would you suggest?
Sure, I would suggest, you know, definitely one looks at a diversified set of options, maybe break it up into about 3 to 4 different funds, whatever is the SIP that one is looking at. He can look at probably HDFC Top 200 is a good fund. Also maybe a Franklin India Blue Chip or a DSP BlackRock Top 100. These for maybe one of these, two of these can be chosen. Look at flexi-cap funds, like, you know, one anywhere between HDFC equity. Even you can look at a, you know, DSP BlackRock equity, and on the mid caps, probably a Sundaram Select mid cap and an ICICI Discovery. So I think four of these, maybe one from each category, and depending on whether he wants to take risk, you know, have an extra one on a mid cap or maybe on a flexi cap or large cap out there.
Sanjeev, Jatin is an engineer. He's aged 25 years. So I'm assuming he's not married and he doesn't have too many financial obligations on him. So should his exposure be more towards the equity side? Should he be aggressively involved? Should large caps be his focus area? What's the kind of portfolio mix would you suggest for him?
See, the, you know, given his age, that he's young and he's, you know, he wants to build, he has a long term to go. So I'll say that his exposure towards equity needs to be higher because at this age, he can afford to take a risk. But, you know, affording to take a risk, you know, I think that he is at the moment investing only in the large cap space. So he can actually take some extra risk in going to the small and the mid cap space and also look at some flexi cap where the fund manager can play around a big bit. So, you know, the funds I would like to recommend to him is look at a DSP, BlackRock, small and mid cap, or an HDFC mid cap opportunities fund. These may be slightly higher risk, but on a long term, they are trying to find companies which are going to become the next big stories of tomorrow. So the kind of upside this type of a fund, you know, if it gets his call right, is able to give is excellent. And also look at some flexi cap where, you know, the fund manager is playing around on the market situation. Like if the market is hot, he'll be in the large cap space. If the market is undervalued, he'll shift more to a mid cap type of a, or a small cap portfolio. So in that case, you know, ICICI approved dynamic is a very good fund, and HDFC equity is a very good fund. So I'll say that be primarily focused on equity and divide your combination between, you know, large cap, which are already there, add in some mid cap and add in some flexi cap and you will have a perfect portfolio.
Okay, so add in a bit of a flexi cap as well. And the names, well, pretty marquee names suggested by our experts for the investor. Sanya Seth joins us from Kolkata. She's a student. Sanya, hi, what's your question?
Hi, sir. Well, actually, I'm in my third year of college and I can invest only up to 8,000 per month. And I was seeking for some SIPs which I could invest in.
Okay.
So which are the SIPs which you recommend?
Are you just beginning to invest? Do you have any other investments right now? Or this is the first step you're beginning to take?
It's the first step, actually. And I also wanted to ask you about the Mediclaim policies, like, you know, LIC Mediclaim or any other Mediclaim policies which you could recommend.
Okay. Fair enough. Sanjeev?
Here. So I like to start with saying LIC doesn't give a Mediclaim policy. So you have to be very careful. See, the LIC or the life insurance health policies are add-on to your Mediclaim policies, which are meant to be taken from the general insurance companies. See, Mediclaim is a reimbursement policy. What it does is that if a person gets hospitalized due to a disease, it will reimburse the cost of those treatment. So that is a pure Mediclaim policy, which has actually very good features. Indian rates are very, very good. But these are Mediclaim policies, but these are not offered by life insurance companies. Life insurance companies basically offer, you know, sort of which are top up to your Mediclaim policies, which are indemnity policies. What they'll do is that in case a person has a problem, they'll give you a lump sum of 1 lakh, 2 lakh or a 5 lakh rupees, depending on the sum insured you have taken to cover your other expenses. Yes, a few life insurance companies do have Mediclaim-like products, but they are not as comprehensive as a normal Mediclaim. So what I would recommend to you is first look at Apollo, Munich, or Max Bupa. They have wonderful premium medical insurances available. If you want some more value for your money, you can look at National, you know, National or any of the PSU. They have got very, very good Mediclaim policies. So first pick up a Mediclaim policy. Again, 8,000 is a very good corpus at your age, and I think if you keep investing, you will have a humongous amount of money by the age you are 50 to 60. And what I'll recommend to you is, again, take a you know, select of 5 or 6 funds. 2 funds have to be large cap, so you can look at an HDFC top 200 or a Franklin Templeton blue chip fund. On the mid-cap space, as I was telling the earlier gentleman, you also need to have mid-cap in your portfolio. There you can look at an HDFC equity or DSP, BlackRock, small and you know, mid-cap. And also you can look at a flexi-cap type of opportunity, which is, you know, HDFC equity is more flexi-cap. So you can look at that or an ICICI approved dynamic. So this will be an ideal portfolio for you.
Well, I wish I would have gotten such an advice when I was beginning to invest. It would have done wonders for me. Well, let me just go across and ask Anil also his views. Before that, well, it seems like D. Subba Rao, the governor of RBI, has just gone to meet the finance minister. And this is, again, the usual norm which we see before the monetary policy move, and usually you don't get to see the RBI governor even commenting a little bit about what he's there to discuss, but again, it's pretty evident. The policy issue is going to be the big one which they're going to discuss. We'll try and see if we can get a quote from the person, from the man himself, but highly unlikely. We'll still try and see if Mr. Subba Rao comments anything on what was the agenda for the discussion. The discussions are currently underway. Anil, let's get your view on what Sanya should do.
Sure. I think Sanya's view of saying that let me look at a Mediclaim medical insurance policy is something which is very good, because what one sees most of the time is, you know, this is probably an area where there's a huge under insurance, you know, out there, and it's not coming into the visibility of too many people either. Today, with the high, you know, medical costs, it's very, very imperative to look at policies like that. I think broadly in sync. In terms of the suggestions there, Apollo Munich definitely has one of the best policies there to use. In terms of the SIPs, I think looking at HDFC Top 200, Franklin India Blue Chip, and maybe a FlexiCap fund like HDFC Equity, or one can also look at a Reliance RSF Equity Fund, and the mid-caps, you know, probably a Sundaram Select Midcap would be my pick in terms of a stable midcap fund there.
Well, Sanya, you have ample number of mutual fund suggestions coming in from our experts that you can actually invest in. And at your age, well, the probability of you retiring as a millionaire is much higher than at least most of the other people. We'll take a break, come back, and we'll discuss more mutual fund and insurance queries with a whole host of other investors. Our phone lines are open right here on BioSec.